This video shows how to define random colors for a 3D object within your AnyLogic model. Specifically, we will show you how to create cars of different colors. This can be done in several ways, and we have previously posted a video with one of the possible solutions. The good point about it is that it works for both 2D and 3D animation. However, it requires creating a bunch of agent types, thus making it long and tedious. This time we'll do it in a much easier way, but the new approach will work for 3D animation only. We'll use the gas station model, which you can find in the oil and gas section of the example models. Run the model and increase the model execution speed. As you can see, only blue cars are arriving at the gas station. Let's add some color to the model. Open the car agent diagram by double-clicking the car tree item in the project's view. The shape at the axis origin is a 3D model that visualizes a car. Select the shape to open its properties. Note the name of the element, car. We will use it when composing our Java code. The colors section lists materials of the 3D object. This material defines the color of the car body. The model developers have changed the default green color to blue. We want this material to vary color for each car the model generates. Click anywhere in the car diagram to open the car agent's properties. Expand the agent action section. We want to change color of the car shape. So we start our Java code in the onStartup field with the shape name car. The names of the Java functions that dynamically change some attribute of an element typically start with the word set. So type set and then invoke code completion master using the control space shortcut. We need the setColor function. Select it and read the function description. This function allows to change the color of the specified 3D shape's material. The important part is that you refer to the material by its name, which is a parameter of type string. The function description informs us to get this name from the 3D object's properties page. The second argument of the function is the new color you set for the material. Double-click the function in the list to add the function call to the code line. Now, we'll navigate to the 3D object's properties to memorize the name of the required material. It is material_4_surf. Please mind that Java programming language is case sensitive, so we should follow the syntax exactly. Now, get back to the properties of the car agent type and insert the name into the function. Since it is a text string, we will enclose the material name in double quotes. Now, we'll specify the value of the second argument of the function, that is, the color of the car. There are several ways to get random colors. One of them is to use the randomColor function. This function randomly chooses one of 140 standard AnyLogic colors, which you can see in the Colors dialog. Each time a new car is created, the car's onStartup code is executed and this function is called. Run the model, and behold, the great abundance of colors. Now, ain't it pretty? If you find some of these random colors too showy, you can explicitly define your own list of possible colors using a collection. Drag the collection from the agent palette to the car diagram and name it Colors. Since the collection will store possible car colors, choose Color from the Elements class drop-down list. To populate the collection with elements, switch the Initial Contents field to the Value Editor and type the color constants separated by commas inside the curly brackets. Click in the car diagram to open the car agent's properties and change the second argument of the setColor function to randomFrom colors. Now, AnyLogic will randomly choose one color from the collection we have just created. Run the model and observe how the beautifully colored cars drive to the gas station. That's it. We've learned several ways of defining random colors for a 3D object. Thanks for watching. Let us know which method you choose in the comments below. If you found the video helpful, leave a like and subscribe to our channel. Come back for more AnyLogic how-to videos.